have to glue down my face. Okay. Take it slow, baby, we no rush. I think I need some Robitussin. I hit the LB with my left hand all like, woo. Yeah, yeah. No need to pretend. She got a little bit of drama front. Back to my channel. So today I have a special guest with me. Clearly, I am in Seattle right now with
the Taylor. I always talk about her on my channel, and it's really
We're
awkward.
Finally, in real life.
Yes. Look well, Taylor and I have been friends actually for 4 years, and we have matching shirts. So you're jealous.
Can you see mine? Because I'm too short.
I've been waiting basically 4 years for Taylor to finally do my makeup, and so I convinced her.
It has.
And if you haven't checked out her channel yet, I mean, I've mentioned her so many times. I'm sure you guys have heard about it before. I'll link it below because she's very, very talented. And we're just gonna like answer some questions and hopefully
look on Instagram
way different.
And then my Snapchat, so we're just gonna.
I wanted her to do my makeup at my wedding, but she said no because that's a little stressful. That's a lot of pressure. I can totally
pressure,
understand. What if you like fucked up my face really bad?
Yeah, that's why I was like, there's no way in hell. I haven't done someone else's makeup in literally, I don't even know, over a year.
Well, she used to work at MAC. So, first question says, what is your favorite part of your body? My favorite part of my body is probably either my legs or my eyes.
Yeah, you have good legs.
Thanks.
Favorite part of my body?
Mm-hmm.
Favorite part of my body is probably eyes or teeth.
If you could live in any country, where would you move to and why?
Like for the rest of your life?
I guess, yeah.
Hmm. Probably Canada, probably Toronto, which I know is like a cop-out answer, but like.
In the six with Drake.
If it was like 10, is that where Drake lives? Oh, he's from Toronto.
The six, yeah. I feel like I would move to Australia. Pretty chill motherfucker.
Australia. Ooh, or New Zealand, actually.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm using an Amazon stick foundation by the way. Super good coverage. I just did a review on this.
Yeah, Taylor does a lot of foundation reviews. If you're looking for a foundation, which I know a lot of women out there are, she does 15 days of foundation. Just, oh my God, you must have like a giant playlist. How many?
Foundation's like my shit. That's like, I love foundation.
Yeah, she does. The other night, Taylor accidentally like washed off her foundation and she was doing a test on it. And I'm such an idiot. I was like, why don't you just put a little back on and kind of make it look like old and then it'll just work fine. She was like, no, I have to like redo it tomorrow. So she's very authentic, clearly is better than me. What is your favorite thing to do in your spare time?
Makeup. YouTube?
Yeah. Research conspiracy theory. Or like just look at people's birth charts and stalk people from
Facebook.
Ooh,
we did that last night. That was really interesting.
Yeah, it is.
Kendall read my birth chart.
Yep, she's a Gemini sun and a Scorpio moon and a Libra ascendant. So we're the same ascendant, which is really cool.
So yeah, still don't really know what that means, but. Going in with Maybelline, what's this? Super Stay Better Skin Concealer. No idea if this will match Kendall. All of my stuff is like pale as shit, so we're just gonna make it work.
What about Taylor made you want to be friends with her and vice versa?
That's a good question.
Probably just like the realness.
Yeah,
like,
same.
Yeah. Taylor's the first person that ever talked to me on YouTube. We like met when I had probably like 200 subscribers or something.
And I don't even remember how I found your channel, honestly.
I don't know either.
I started watching Kendall and I was like, this girl's chill. She's, and this was back when like 4 years ago when all of the beauty channels were like cookie cutter.
Yeah.
Not anything. And you started out kind of as like beauty.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh no,
more,
I poured
into beauty. I could just like tell you were being real and like being yourself.
Same with you.
It's gross if I use my sponge for your powder.
No, I don't care.
Alright, Kendall's giving me approval. Don't want to see any shit comments.
My viewers don't care about stuff like that, trust me. They're just here to listen to us talk, probably.
Do you guys care about makeup?
Some of them probably do.
That looks hella good under your eyes.
Wait, really?
Can you just look at, do you want to see? Oh, you're looking in the viewfinder.
I can't see it.
You can't.
I have mistaken.
Okay, do you want to wait?
If I close one eye, I can see it.
It looks like very, this. I've never set my eyes with this because this is like too light. This is a Better Skin Powder by Maybelline.
Ooh.
In the lightest shade.
Would you rather not be allowed to wear makeup the rest of your life or only be able to wear hot pink Crocs for the rest of your life? Fuck.
Oh God.
That's hard. That's really hard.
I would do Crocs just because makeup brings me so much joy in life. Like, I would do Crocs and just wear like long ass dresses all the time.
Yeah, I would do the same.
Wow, that's saying a lot because I fucking hate Crocs.
Oh, I thought they were the best when I was a
kid. You wore Crocs?
Like, oh, when I was like in sixth grade.
Good
look. I was so mad at my mom because I wanted Crocs for my birthday so bad. And she got me like grass green colored Crocs and all I wanted was pink. I was so fucking pissed. What do you want to name your children or another cat?
Or another cat.
Well, I met a really cool cat last night named Archie. I really liked Archie.
Kendall literally almost started crying in the car when we had to say bye.
Yeah, that's because I realized that I was never gonna see Archie again, and she was a really great cat.
I was like, Kendall, you literally have 3 cats at home.
It's not enough. Like, I need more.
I'm not one of those people who like thinks about this at night.
Josh and I have some weird ass names. We want to name our kids like weird like celebrity. Like,
well, so you're like on the path. Like, if I was on your path, like I would know my kids' names by now. But
really, like for a boy, like the name Cyrus.
Like Cyrus.
Isn't that weird?
I like really? It though.
Well, and then Josh and I also like the name Phantom with an F, and we literally just made it up. And we'd probably get bullied, so it probably won't happen. I like the name Gretel, but Josh hates it.
Please do not name your child Gretel.
No one likes it. I'm sorry if your name is Gretel.
Hansel and Gretel.
Yeah, I just think it's like cool to like make old names like popular again. I like Harlow, Luna.
Oh, I like Harlow.
The Harlow cool name. Taylor, do you have any tattoos?
I do not.
No?
I would though. They're coming out with temporary ink. Have you heard about that?
No.
They're coming out with ink that literally lasts like a year or two.
Oh, that would be cool.
I would totally do it if it would only last 2 years.
Yeah.
I just like, I'm too indecisive for tattoos.
Well, once you get them, you like get addicted. So I have 3 already. I have at least 3 more that I want
to
do.
That's the thing. I also get like super addicted to things like that, like piercings and stuff. So I know I would just go crazy if I got one tattoo. This is the Wet n Wild contouring palette.
Oh my god, my sister asked a question. What are your ethnicities to both of you lovely ladies? I don't really know what I am like completely. I'm definitely mainly Italian, Irish, and Jewish, but I don't know like the percentages.
I'm Polish, Russian. I'm actually like a quarter Russian, which I just learned like a few months ago.
I can totally see that. This is the one from my sister. She says, would you rather wear a snowsuit in the Sahara Desert or be a naked ass in Antarctica?
Oh, definitely naked in Antarctica.
I think so too. Easy. Yep.
Can you imagine wearing a snowsuit in the desert? I would just kill myself.
For Taylor, what is your opinion on the Kylie lip kicks?
They're pretty much like identical to ColourPop, honestly, like unless you really want to just support Kylie, which like you do you.
Support her because she's barely getting by.
She really needs some support. Guys. Go help her out.
She can't pay her
really
rent.
She's struggling.
She needs a GoFundMe.
Yeah, like unless you're buying it for her name brand, just stick with ColourPop because they're honestly like the same thing. Stila Stay All Day liquid lipsticks are like some of the best. Lipstick formulas. Uh-huh. This is the NYX Baked Bluss. I'm being really shit
about
Bluss. Baked Bluss.
Bleh Bluss.
These are pretty shit when you first get it, so you have to like scrape off the
pretty
top layer.
Shit.
Yeah, pretty good shit.
Since you are from Colorado, do you think you'll ever do a meet here? I'm guessing meet and greet. Well, we met someone the other night at, shout out to Michaela, or it was a really pretty name. Anyway.
At Outback?
Yeah, she works at Outback. She was super, super nice, and Josh was like over the moon that someone knew who he was. And so now he's like, we should do a meetup. So I think if Josh did it with me, I'd be more comfortable. It's just really scary. I can't explain to you guys the feeling of like someone knowing everything about you and I don't even know like their names. Like I love meeting it's easier when it's just one person coming up to you, but I've done a meetup and there's like 30 people and it was really fun, but I had to like sleep for a long time after it.
I think it's just like, it's really cool meeting people in real life, but it's also like just, it's like your safety at the end of the day. And like there's certain things that just, and especially with like, Kendall talks about like controversial shit on her channel. Like for me, it's like a different story, but for someone that actually talks about things that like people get really livid over.
Exactly.
It's a lot more dangerous.
I don't know. I'll keep you guys posted. I definitely want to. I don't know. I wish I had a bodyguard.
I'll be your bodyguard.
That was cool. I'm sure you'd do a really good job. Yeah. That one's really hard, but what's your favorite makeup product?
Foundation.
What's your favorite foundation?
Like if I could only wear one for the rest of my life, probably Marc Jacobs Remarkable, because you can just like majorly, if you need less coverage, you can literally use like the tiniest bit. If you need full coverage, it's like fucking amazing.
It is.
It's worth every single penny and it'll literally last you for years.
$55 fucking dollars.
But it's totally worth it.
Taylor keeps telling me to buy it. I got a sample, but I'm too cheap to buy it. Oh, yeah. Oh, you have it?
I don't think I have a darker shade for you. So I just put the Physicians Formula Shimmer Brick. This is the most amazing drugstore highlighter ever.
What is your favorite holiday?
I think New Year's. New Year's Eve.
Really?
I really like the whole, like, starting over and, like, reflecting on life thing.
I'm boring Christmas.
Christmas.
Yeah, I like Halloween, though, too.
What's our least favorite holiday?
Fucking Groundhog Day, I guess. So since your plans of to move to Florida have changed, you guys plan on moving into a home where you are living now or anytime soon, or do you still want to wait a few years? We're just gonna stay in the same apartment, but I know it's crazy because I just said I'm not moving, but like I swear I would love to live here in Seattle. I am blown away by this city. Like if you live here, I'm really jealous. It's like, it's just such a cool place and I would definitely consider moving here because I don't think I can. I've lived in Colorado forever and as great as it is, a great state, I just really like feel like I need to experience some other things. Sometimes my foundation looks too cakey or doesn't match my skin tone.
how can I fix this?
This is one.
If it doesn't match your skin tone, you can use any kind of like foundation mixer, whether it's, it feels weird I'm not like,
yeah, you should like
at the thing. You can use any kind of you can use any kind of foundation mixer, or if it's, or if you need like a foundation that's like not yellow enough, just mix in a yellow concealer or a white product like Manic Panic Dream Tone. There's like 5 billion different foundation mixers now.
How do you stop it from being cakey?
Setting spray. Try out different powders or like primers too. I feel like setting spray helps me a lot. Okay, so for eyeshadow, we're gonna try out the Morphe by Kathleen Lights palette. This is brand new.
Oh, she did a palette?
Yeah.
She just shouted out my channel. I was like, that's so cool. I didn't know she had a palette.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna buy it just because she's nice.
I've used it one time. So far, I like it. The black is literally the blackest black I've ever seen in my life.
Did you put on primer already?
Yeah.
What'd you use for primer?
Primer, I used the Lancome La Base.
La Base. What's your best tip for eyeshadow?
Like, where do you,
I'm asking, like, what?
What do you think of this?
What do you start with? Like, do you do like the lid or the crease or the high? Like, wait, I never know which.
I always start with like the blending. So like whatever I'm blending into the crease. Mm-hmm. So usually like, I mean, I don't know. I always do a couple shades darker than like your face. But like with a brush like this, this is the Morphe M511. I always talk about this on my channel, but Morphe is like super hit or miss. I feel like just like be careful with what brushes you buy, but like some of the ones I'm gonna be using today, I like totally recommend.
Favorite ice cream flavor? Hers is not chocolate.
I don't like ice cream that much.
She doesn't like chocolate.
Ben and Jerry's brownie, like if I was force-fed ice cream.
I like the cotton candy blizzard. Shit's really
cotton
good.
Cotton candy blizzard from Dairy Queen?
Yeah. Or like a birthday cake flavor.
Oh, birthday cake. Coldstone birthday cake with brownies. Okay, I'm taking this shade right here, which is like shit brown. And then I'm going in with the Morphe R39. That's why I like, if you do your lid color last, you can like blend, or not last, but like after this step, you can blend as far in as you want here, and then put your lid on, and then you can just like really lightly blend over it. And I feel like it just looks a lot more flawless.
Which Harry Potter movie is your favorite?
I have no feelings about Harry Potter.
Yeah, agreed.
Really? I thought you liked Harry Potter.
I don't even think I've seen them all.
I haven't either. That's rare.
Yeah.
All right, we're moving over to my Snapchat. MellyBelly143, what's your workout routine? Non-existent, that's mine. Kendall's good about it.
I normally do like 3 or 4 days a week, and I do 45 minutes on the elliptical at like level 16. Try to do 16.
16? Yeah. Damn.
Well, that's how I get my good legs.
I was gonna say, like, I wonder.
I have really, really strong legs because of it. Feels good to sweat, dude. Like, it's like total therapy for me. I love it.
Juice Shifted asks, any hidden talents?
0%. No.
You've got to have one.
Literally not talented. I can blow O's.
You can what?
Like blow O's like with smoke.
Yeah, that's good. That's a good skill. Good job.
And I'm not even that good at that, honestly. I don't know. I'm really not that talented.
Oh, this is a good one. This is like a, not this. This is not a good one. She said, what annoys you about the other and what do you admire the most? Let's do what do you admire the most.
Okay. Taylor's like a really, really hard worker, like very driven, got up 3 hours earlier than me, like both days, very organized and like, just like a hard worker.
I think I would say Kendall is like very caring, and like you can tell, like I was at her wedding, and you can tell that she genuinely cares about my religious stuff. She genuinely cares about the people in her life and aww. Josh and her cats and just, you know.
I do care about my cats. It's funny, I was thinking about it the other day, like, I think I like my cats more than, like, most people I know, like, for sure. Obviously, Taylor did come all the way out for my wedding, and I felt so bad, because we only got to talk for, like, 15 minutes, like, the whole time. It was so overwhelming. And Josh was, like, so sad, because he didn't get to meet her. The whole thing was, like, two seconds
really
long.
Yeah, I really wish I
got to meet Josh. I know. Okay. Well, you'll meet him eventually.
Aaron C. Bird says, how do you handle negative comments? And we were talking about this.
Bye.
I feel like a lot of people don't realize that we're literally humans behind a computer, and a lot of times, even if you're saying something that isn't that horrible, like, we both have a pretty freaking thick skin, yeah, I feel like, and we've learned to by YouTube, but when it's like comment after comment after comment after comment sometimes, it like really, it's just rude. It's just like, just put positivity out in the world, and like that's what you're gonna get, and that's why a lot of times we just like delete the bad comments and block people.
I block them. I have so many blocks set up.
Yeah, and people just get like people argue with each other, and I think that's the thing that really bothers me is like I just don't want that negativity on my channel or like with each other, and it's just like, why? Just don't do it. Just put out positive thoughts. If you don't have them, just close out the video.
She said, how do you handle it? We're like just lecturing them not to
do it. Don't do it.
Sometimes I'll literally type a response and then just delete it, and it makes me feel a little better.
Have you had any paranormal experiences? Says Taylor1124.
Yeah.
You have?
Yeah, I have two videos. Oh, dude, I was like being straight up haunted. You didn't see the one where I got like scratched?
I didn't want to watch that. I was like, I'm gonna have horrible dreams for the rest of my life.
It was really freaky.
I don't know. I guess not. I guess if I don't know, it's the answer's no.
Yeah.
Matt says, how do you feel confident without makeup? I have acne and I want to feel confident. YouTube has really helped with my confidence.
Yeah, me
like,
too.
First of all, like you don't feel like you're talking to anyone. So like first time I put up a video without any makeup, I didn't really think anything of it because you feel like you're not talking to anyone. You just kind of get used to it, and you're getting like so many messages and stuff from people being like, thank you for showing like your skin and what it really looks like. And I have like major acne and stuff if you guys haven't seen anything, but I don't know. I think just like learning to embrace it and realize that like everyone has flaws, like some kind of flaw, and instead of seeing it as a flaw, just like learn to live with it and like,
mm-hmm. And the thing is everyone is more worried about themselves to even care what you look like.
Yeah.
That's what I really realized is it has been YouTube that's changed it for me, but I think it can really affect everyone because what I've realized is people have been like, don't really care that I'm not wearing makeup. No one's like, oh, you hideous beast, why aren't you wearing makeup? Like, same thing with you guys, like in real life, if you don't wear makeup, no one's like sitting there being like, oh my God, I wish that bitch would put on some makeup. Like, how ugly are you?
I used to like in high school, if I wasn't wearing makeup one day, I would literally, that was like all I could focus on was the fact that I wasn't wearing makeup and like, what were people thinking of me? And like, yeah, no one is thinking about it. No one is thinking about it.
Yeah, someone's in the front row. God, I wish Taylor would cover her face.
God damn it.
She's so ugly, it's distracting me. My eyes almost just like rolled back all the way. I felt like I couldn't bring them down for a second.
Someone just asked if we would ever surrogate a baby for the other if necessary.
That is some fucking deep shit.
I think that's the most intense question I've ever gotten asked.
I peed in front of her like 30 minutes ago, but I don't know. That's really crazy.
That's on a whole new level.
Yeah. I feel like Kylie's makeup artists always get like annoyed with her because she's like Snapchatting during it, and they always look like they're like annoyed by her doing that.
You know Kim Kardashian.
I know all of their signs, all of them. Chloe's a
what
Cancer.
Is Kim?
Kim's a Libra. Kanye is a Gemini. Well, he's like innovative and creative. Chris is a Scorpio. Kendall's a Scorpio. Kylie is a Leo. Courtney is a Aries. I can't believe I know all of them. That is so embarrassing. I know all of their signs.
Like celebrity.
Yeah, I should.
Horoscopes or something.
Yeah, I'm about to pretend I'm Kylie Jenner.
My pet peeve is the way they snap. They fucking with them.
Yeah, that's what I'm about to do.
I'm like, what the fuck? What are you doing? That's literally we're gonna attempt to go into false lashes. Kara S.
Oh, we are?
I'll never be like you.
If you could choose each other's hairstyles and the other person had no input, what would you choose for each other?
That's a good one. I would seriously just do yours the way it is, though. It looks so good.
I would probably keep yours the way it is, too. I think the awkward thing
was so boring.
So it's my birthday
today. Happy birthday!
Really hard to be Kylie.
Yeah, Kylie being Kylie's exhausting. I get it.
Yeah, it's just really tiring.
It's a rough life.
Mm-hmm. And I have to like pick, like I need to pick out like a couple different names for my lip kits tonight, and like I have to have it in by tonight, and like I've already used all of the names I know. Like, no, I might have a color called Kanye, thinking that it'll be something like really obnoxious.
We're going in with Ofra Harlem liquid lipstick. She wants like a vampy purple, so Ofra Harlem, and I think I'm gonna mix in a little bit of Ofra Hypno.
Somebody come tip her, she's dancing like a strip. own creations. I made them in the lab.
The same lab that colorful pieces. Yeah, it's actually, you didn't know that?
Y'all buy that shit, y'all getting played. Like, what the fuck? That's no, in the same lab?
Yeah, that's what I was telling you.
Same. Why do lab, people buy exact? It?
That's what it, yeah, I know.
What a joke. All right, guys. It's been really fun pretending to be Kylie Jenner for the last hour, but...
Ooh, I'm tired. I'm like seriously ready for wine and sleep.
Yeah, we're gonna get some wine and sleep. So, definitely subscribe to Taylor's channel. As you can see, she's like super talented. Like, if you're looking for makeup content...
Do you like it? You didn't even see it up close.
Well, I've been like watching myself on Snapchat. Oh my god, it looks amazing. Wow. Definitely go to Taylor's channel and we are gonna do this with her.
Like no like, hands. Yeah. Kendall is doing my
It's gonna be face. Really fucking funny.
Up and down, up and down. Get it really good. And if you inhale some powder, it's great. Even more. Oh, don't forget your ear. You always want to contour your ear. I'm going for more of a Barney look today, so this is perfect. It's so hard to find your brows sometimes. We have Kylie. There might be half product missing, but it's okay. You paid $40 for it, but you're never gonna use it all, so don't worry, it's Kylie. So now I'm gonna do some of my poses because I have to get that good thumbnail and I gotta get an Instagram photo. Yeah, okay.
I will talk to you guys next time.
Bye. It's so cold, I'm not blinking. What in the world was I thinking? Today, no money to be made. There is nothing to explain.